all of you. Thank you so much for those kind words. Let me first express my gratitude to the management of the Institute for giving me this opportunity to come and address the students and share my experiences over the years. If you look at the slide, it says former head statutory business. So the good part is that I'm currently a student addressing a group of students out here. So I'm sure the session is going to be interesting and we'll try to make it as meaningful as possible. The other thing is we'd like to make it as interactive, so please feel free to ask questions. While we'll have a session at the end, but you can interrupt during the course of the day so that we make it as meaningful and you can get some value out of it. We are talking about key accounts management. Before I begin, I would want to ask that what does key accounts to any of you suggest? What is the first thing which comes to your mind? What is a key account? Anyone? I mean, anyone? Any thoughts on key accounts? Any thoughts? If we have MBA students. First years or anyone of the first year? No thoughts? Come on, I'm sure there'll be some thoughts. What is the key account in sales or in the field of marketing? Chalo, I'm sure we'll take it as we'll go up. Yeah, anyone? Key areas of management. Okay. Any other thoughts? Any other thoughts? Okay. So we'll come back to it. My introduction talked of a lot of years spent with media organizations, especially DNA, HT, and the Times of India. So I'll be giving you certain examples from the media industry and the print industry. So it's very important for us to understand a perspective of what's happening in the media sector currently. And I'm sure a lot of you young students also would be interested in making a career, because media is currently at an inflection point and it's in a very exciting stage and offers tremendous amount of career opportunities in the field of sales and marketing, even finance. I'm told the single biggest percentage of people currently graduating would be into finance. So that even makes it more interesting. So just let's look at a broad snapshot of what's happening in media and advertising. And what is the future hold for this industry for the next year? Very, very briefly. It's roughly around 50,000 crores, 49,500 crores, expected to grow at around 13.5%, which is incidentally is a very, very robust growth rate. Double digit growth rates. There are not very sectors today in this country which is actually clocking at double digit growth rates. So 13.5% projection is actually very, very healthy. So what's happening? How much is television? Broadly, just to give a snapshot, TV is around 21,000 crores. TV has overtaken print in the last 5-6 years in this country. Traditionally, print was always ahead of television. That has changed. That's the one big, huge trend which we see. So TV and print is currently at par. 21,000, 19,500. Next is digital. Single biggest growth in this country the last 6 years is coming from digital. 9,000 plus crores. Last year it grew at 40%, this year is expected to grow at 25%. Digital marketing, I'm sure you would be studying as a subject here out here, but apart from the institute giving its inputs, it's very important that you students take your own initiative, do online courses, read, increase your knowledge as far as digital is concerned. Because end of the day, any management institute is an enabler, it's a facilitator. End of the day, it is your initiative as to how you're going to go to take things forward in life. Digital is the future. 9,000 crores. Digital 5 years back was not even 3,000 crores as far as advertising is concerned. Today it's 9,000 crores. Rest, of course, you've got radio, you've got OOH is out of home, and you've got cinema. Radio is growing around 15%, cinema is growing around 10%, out of home is growing around 15%. So this is a broad snapshot. So largely as far as media is concerned in this country, it's television and print that takes around roughly 80% of the current revenues. So this is important for you to understand just at the back of your mind as to what's happening, what's in store. Key accounts. Very simple to put in. If I am Apollo Hospital and I have got a unit which is into executive checkup, so I have got a retail unit and a corporate unit. In corporate unit, if I have 10 clients, which client is giving me how much business? Who are my top 5 clients who give me 80% of my business? There is something called the Pareto's law, the 20-80 law. 20% of clients are responsible for 80% of revenues. So those 20% clients are key accounts or major accounts. This concept started off from the office automation industry in the 90s and the late 80s in this country. And today there is no sector in sales or marketing which is not following this practice of key account management or key accounts. So that is basically a key or a major account, which I thought we are going to share some light on these.
Yeah.
So it's a high revenue producer offering opportunities to increase sales, loyal business partners, and their important opinion leaders. So basically, if my client is giving me huge amount of revenues, I can't afford to ignore. I need to take special care of him. So that is called key account management. So key accounts, so you have the key account management. Strategic business approach with the objective of ensuring long-term and sustainable business development. It's not an isolated process. It's very much part of the sales strategy or the marketing strategy. So that's key accounts. What does it do? Maximize sales. End of the day, you are in the business of maximizing revenues. Whether it is a Coke, whether it is a Pepsi, whether it is a Times of India, whether it is a HT, whether it's a Maruti, whether it's a General Motors. Top lines and bottom lines. Bottom lines is a function of top lines. How do you sustain business? How do you grow business? Organically as well as inorganically. That's what key account management does. Increase the deal size. If my client is giving me 100 rupees per month, how do I increase it to 150 rupees per month? What is the kind of strategy I am going to have? Customer loyalty. It's very simple that the cost of retaining a customer is much less than the cost of acquiring a customer. In fact, it's 1/3. So key account management helps you to retain that customer rather than acquiring the customer. Value partners. Retaining will only happen if you give value to your clients. The key word today, the buzzword, is value. It's all going to be about value-based selling. How do I add value to my clients, irrespective of the function? Be it sales, be it HR, be it finance. How do I add value? Whichever organization I'm going to work for, whether I'm an external customer or I'm an internal customer. So every organization have their own metrics. You know, how do you classify key accounts? If I am HT, I've got different verticals. I've got an automobile vertical. I've got a consumer durable vertical. I've got a government vertical. I have a retail vertical. I have a real estate vertical. So in every vertical, if I've got 100 clients, I see which are my top 20 clients, which is giving me a bulk of my business. And I do treat those clients separately. That's how I classify. So largely organizations, how do they classify? Business commitment. One client says, I'll give you 1 crore per annum. Other client says, boss, I'll give you 3 crores per annum. That becomes my commitment. Market share. One guy says, I'm going to commit you 50% market share. The second client says, I'm going to give you a 70% market share. Give me a better deal. That's market share. Growth, pricing, performance linked incentives. So parameters varies from industry to industry, from clients to clients, but largely the metric followed is largely these parameters. There may be certain more parameters also. But it's by and large on these parameters which this happens there. So what is key account management actually telling of? It's basically telling us today that we need to think on behalf of the clients if we are going to be in business. That's the period. That's the buzzword. That is what all of you future leaders of tomorrow, when you're going to join the industry, is going to do. Irrespective whether you're going to be sales and whether you're going to do marketing. Whether you're going to do finance, people who are going to take finance specialization or getting into finance also need to understand key account management as much as people who are into sales or marketing. Because finance today works very, very closely with marketing and sales. The days of isolations are over. You'll be in two teams, you'll be interacting, you'll be working joint strategies. So there is no longer organizations are working in silos. In fact, they're working more and more jointly and towards team effort. So from a financial point of view, you need to look at how can I maximize revenue from my client? Give inputs. Take it up. So we've got something in bank. When you open a bank account, they say nothing will happen. if your KYC form is not there, know your customer, it has to be linked with Aadhaar and whatnot. Is the same KYC there when tomorrow we're going to start working and you have a client? How well do you know the client? Just a professional meeting with the client won't help. That is past, that's history. Won't help at all. Culturally, from where does he come for? What are his interests? Community, hobby. To what extent can you leverage that client? Because end of the day, when you have a sales target or whether you have a solutions target, it is you and the client. How do you go about it? That's the issue. Let's see some examples. So I'm taking example of a South Indian paper called Malayalam Manorama. I don't know how much would you know, but it's the number one newspaper in Kerala. It's a Malayalam paper, extremely strong and powerful in Kerala. Any advertising campaign cannot happen or break if it is not there in that paper. The reason why I'm giving an example of South is I would have given examples of Times of India or NHT. But to give you a perspective of what is happening in regional publications, how important are language and regional publications in this country, very few will you be having an idea. Because regional print is growing at a much faster rate than English. Please understand, English is not growing well compared to language and region. And I have a slide later which I'll tell you. Hindi and language in newspapers are growing at a very, very healthy rate. The reason is today in this country, as the economy is looking up, the entire action is happening in tier 3, tier 4 and tier 5 cities. It is not only tier 1 and tier 2, the metros which we see it. So we'll come to that. So Onam, you all know Onam, how important Onam is for South. So what do? You make posters, go to the client's office, tell them that we are celebrating Onam. See the connect. This is at the client's office. Yeah? Posters. Organization takes the initiative. The marketing support takes the initiative. That's how you leverage, connect. End of the day, it is all about client connect, engagement. Tent cards at their workstations from the publication. And I'm telling you, I'm giving you an example of a publication is a number one in their region. There is no campaign which will break without them. Even then, see the kind of effort they are putting just to ensure that you get a top of mind recall. So when the client thinks of a publication, he thinks of the person X who's servicing the account. This is all one-to-one client connect at the client's office. Onam, Rangoli being made at the reception of the client. So this is basically the slides to show to open up your thinking faculties. To what extent you need to manage that account. Happy Onam. This is all Gurgaon office. These are all actual things which the organization has done. So these are not dummy snaps. Lamp lighting at the reception. So can you imagine if you're calling the client or the agency and the five of their top middle management or the senior level management people for the lighting? You can imagine what would be going out in their mind. They'll be probably be remembering this incident for the next 6 months. And maybe they would be talking to hundreds of people that listen. These are the people from these publications who came to our office and celebrated Onam. See the kind of connect we are talking of. Yeah? Any questions so far? Is it understandable? Yeah? Can't hear. See the connect. This is a media planner. Media buyer, media planner in an advertising agency. To what extent you will now have to go out to ensure that you have your client or the agency connect. It is not about you do a sales call, you do a marketing call, you make an advertising campaign and it's over. Those days are history. Performance happening at the reception of the clients. Kerala Day. We're celebrating Kerala Day. You make quiz. This is the fortune, wheel of fortune. Keep holding it. Tell him to put a thing like a dart. Give prizes. You give prizes, vouchers, coupons, votes. What is the end of the day? What is the objective? Objective is top of mind recall. Objective is engagement. Objective is next time when he's planning business, there are 30 newspapers. My paper should be top of mind. My product should be top of mind. This is all share of the mind. Before you get the share of the wallet, each leads to the other. Yeah. Mahabali, they've made it. And he's coming and moving on. Taste of Kerala. So how do we go about it? You have to get into it. How do you do it is something, a strategy which you need to make. Organization obviously is there. Products, come out with features, come out with value. Extend the market. Develop the market. Market is stagnant. You won't develop the market, someone else will do. Create new segments. You'll have to do it. You don't do it, someone else will take those market shares. So while there's product development happening from the marketing and the production side, there's also the sales and the sales support happening. Both are happening in tandem. That's how you do it. That's how you take it on to the next level. There are challenges also, so I'm mentioning it very, very, I don't want to dwell so much into challenges. Key accounts has its own challenges. I may say, for example, let's say a full page ad in Times of India costs a lakh rupees. So I have a client like Samsung. Samsung says, okay, I was giving you 10 full pages in a year at 1 lakh rupees. I'll give you 30 full pages in a year. But I won't give you at 1 lakh rupees. Give me at 85,000. Should you take it? Should you leave it? Why? Absolutely, bang on. Bang on, very good. So the revenue commitment has gone up. जहाँ वो मुझे 10 पेज दे रहा था वो मुझे 30 पेज दे रहा है. But look at the flip side, there is something called yields. There is something called realization, which means one page was costing 1 lakh. Now he's giving you a commitment of 30 pages. So the top line has gone up. But your realization per page has dropped. Have you understood? Your realization per page has dropped. So this is a catch 22 situation. Obviously 99% of the time every publication does not say no and takes it. So you're absolutely right. But this is an issue which we need to address. How do we ensure that the realization does not go down and the top line goes up? Huge challenge before marketers. No easy answers. Huge, huge, huge challenge in every industry. You can take it. You can see it in your case also. You go, you buy a television, he gives you an X price. Tell him I want to buy 3 television sets. He'll reduce it. Definitely, he can't say no in today's world. He'll reduce it. But then what happens to his realization? That's the issue for the organization. So anyway, so I just wanted to touch about it. We'll not dwell on challenges today. We'll dwell more on the pluses and the advantages. So that's more interesting. So what's the business paradigm? What we have been talking of? Any industry, if you're going to do business today, traditional company or the MNC, e-commerce, any industry, any sector, you need to acquire the client, you need to serve the client, you need to retain the client. This is the Bible. All strategies for every organization will be centered around this Bible. How do we do it? $1 million question. On one side, we are talking about retention. Second time, all of you are also consumers. I mean, India is 65% of our population is under the age of 35. That's the kind of potential. All of you are consumers yourself. You may buy the first book on Flipkart, you may buy the second book on Amazon. I'm sure you would be doing it all the time. How does Flipkart ensure customer loyalty is the biggest challenge which he's facing. How does Amazon ensure that the next time you're buying something, you buy from Amazon, not Flipkart or not Snapdeal? That is the challenge marketers today are facing at. Again, there's no easy answer. They're churning out data, they're trying to understand the customer better. There's a huge field of analytics which has now started in this country the last few years. Data analytics, marketing analytics, data scientists, you're churning out huge loads of data, trying to analyze the consumer. Age group, preference, what does he buy, when does he buy, which website does he buy, what time of the day does he buy, and see that there can be trends, which then can be analyzed and there can be a market offering. So you analyze, reassess, change. So as I said, there are three objectives. One is your business objective for your organization. Your company has certain resources, and there are marketing opportunities. So you need to marry. This is the paradigm. You need to marry the three. How do you do it? The resources, the opportunities, and then an objective. So you need to manage people. Obviously, the be all and end all in an organization, whether you have your own startup or whether you're working in an organization. Huge amount of skills needed today than they were needed 15, 20, or 25 years back. Because earlier, teams used to be isolated. Each one was used to working with himself. Today, all that, last 10 years, everything has changed. Today, you're only working in teams. There is nothing called I. It is only we. There is no I today in whichever function you're going to be today. So your skills in team dynamics is actually going to be making or breaking your career, period, whether you like it or not. Your interpersonal skills, your ability to handle criticism, your ability to work with people with diverse backgrounds, and also your ability to work with people who are going to be 5 years, 6 years, 8 years younger than you, let me assure you, after 5, 6 years of years. Your next boss is going to be younger than you. Bitter truth. May not like it, you can't do anything about it. So how do you manage with them? So these are skills which you need to be sensitized. Institute can only do that much across, but these are things which you'll have to learn. How do you do it? How do you work in a team? How do you work in a group? How do you take out your best? There are going to be teams across functions, across geographies, across regions. Isolation ab hoga nahi, those days are over, history. You cannot say, no, I did my job well, but that guy was there with me, you know, he had inertia. Won't work. There is only groups today. While you may have individual KRAs, but 90% of the time you are going to be working in groups in terms of meeting those KRAs, unfortunately. So a lot of clients, the best of clients today in the country, are re-looking at your current appraisal systems, because appraisal systems were designed for the individual performance. But you are working today in groups, so there is a huge disconnect. There's a huge disconnect. So a lot of people are saying, no, we will not do that. So appraisal has got no meaning today, and they are reworking at systems. Appraisal is supposed to be once a year. एक साल का आज के दिन में अगले मंथ का पता नहीं है कि विच प्रोजेक्ट आई एम गोइंग टू बी देयर सो दैट वन ईयर मीनिंग हैज गॉट नो मीनिंग एट ऑल पीपल आर लुकिंग एट क्वार्टरली परफॉर्मेंस रिव्यू सो एनीवे दीज आर जस्ट ट्रेंड्स फॉर मी टू शेयर सो इफ आई एम अ न्यूज़पेपर व्हाट एम आई डूइंग इफ आई एम अ मलयालम मनोरमा इफ आई एम अ हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स इफ आई एम अ टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया व्हाट एम आई सेलिंग हुम आर वी सेलिंग Why should that customer buy from me? Why should I advertise if I'm a client? Why should I advertise in HT and not Times of India? Or the other way around? So whom does a newspaper selling to? Who's the customer for a newspaper? Who's the customer for a newspaper? Who's the customer? Fine, that he's an advertiser. Fine. But why is Adidas wanting to advertise in HT? Why does he advertise in HT? Huh? So what? Reaching whom? Whom is it reaching? Audience. Exactly. Nice. Good. So what business are we in? Very important. I am in the business of giving an audience. That is why Adidas is advertising in my newspaper, because that newspaper is going to reach certain amount of households. Some amount of households from that may like the ad. They go to the Adidas store and buy the store. So we are in the business of audience. Very, very important. Extremely important. You need to be very clear. So whatever your strategies are, it's going to be made against, go to that audience there and then look at it or market. So when I say audience, audience comes from a particular market. So if it is a Kerala, you see Kerala, they've got so many editions. They're completely, they are a monopoly in Kerala, different regions. So if Adidas wants to do a program in Kollam, let's say he has a new, let's say they launch a new shoe, they've just launched a, let's say a float ride. And they want to do a test market in Kollam. So they'll take that edition which only goes to Kollam. And so on and so forth. This is very important. I thought I'll just share with you. Why did I give example of a regional paper and not an English paper? See, newspapers have got readership. They've got circulation and then they've got readership. And on the basis of readership, the media planners decide, depending on the campaign, how much money to put in what newspaper. So higher the readership of the newspaper, by more people it is being read, the better it is. More the revenues the newspaper gets. See who's number one. This is 2014 data, because after that readership survey did not happen, but the trend is the same even today after 3 years. Who's number two? Who's number three? All three Hindi. That is why I gave the example of a Hindi or a region. Well, we all may be enamored by HT Cities and Delhi Times. Hamari to duniya wahi khatam ho jati hai. DT padh lo. Main paper kya karna hai? Wo to online aa jayega. That's a trend which is happening. My daughter never even looks at the main paper. First thing she wants is Delhi Times. Period. But as far as the country is concerned, as far as circulation growth is concerned, as far as revenues are concerned, it is not English anymore. English was dominant in this country for the last 30 years. That trend is slowly changing, or rather changed in the last 5, 6, 7, 8 years. And why has this trend happened? Why is Hindi on top? Any guesses? Why is Hindi on top? Huh? Fine, great, yes. And what else? Why is Hindi doing so well in this country?
So most of the age groups people read Hindi newspaper as compared to the youngsters.
Yeah, sure.
And youngsters can Google it out the news, and they're having a many application like InShort and something which gives us a brief information about the all over the world.
Great. Hindi is doing well because the way economy has boomed in this country in the last 10 years, there's money available now in tier 3, tier 4, tier 5 towns. Their aspirations have gone up. They've got disposable income. If you ever go and travel to small towns and villages, you'll be shocked what is the kind of changes and demographics happening in this country. Who are the people today who are driving BMWs? Audi, Merc and BMW, how many dealers do they have in Punjab? Please find out. You're all management students. Find out how well is a BMW and a Merc doing in a place like Chandigarh. You'll be shocked. In a place like Amritsar, Ludhiana, Haryana, Hisar, you'll be shocked to know. There is money available in small towns, in tier 3 and tier 4 towns. They are reading Hindi, they are reading language. We are one of the biggest suppliers of producers of two-wheelers in the one month, in the year, in this country. Ask what percentage of Hero Honda is only selling to the villages. It's more than 50%. So when demonetization happened, the two-wheeler industry got affected big time. Why? Because 50% of their clients were in villages and small towns. can't ignore them anymore. Lot of things, metro is coming down, growth rates in metro for a lot of product categories are coming down, let me assure you. And it's coming up from your other cities, and that's how the balance is coming into. English is at number 8, the only English daily in the top 10 readership is Times of India. It's at number 8. Look at Malayala Manorama, that's why I gave examples of Malayala Manorama and not for Times of India or HT. Number 4, how strong the brand is. Matrubhumi, their competition is Matrubhumi, that's number 9. And the only Marathi daily, Lokmat, is number 10. So there's just one English out of 10, the either Hindi or their language. So what does that mean? Means that all those people who are trying to, who's wanting to make a career in the print media industry, should you be joining an English paper or a Hindi or a language paper? So that's where the answer lies. That's where the answer lies. So that's why I thought I'll keep this slide, just to sensitize on what's happening in this country, what's happening in the media landscape. Yeah? So let's look at some examples, some small examples of connecting. Because end of the day, we are talking about connect. End of the day, we are talking about engagement. End of the day, we are talking about getting more monies. I mean, that's what key account management in a nutshell is all about. Mujhe paisa nikalna hai. Period. How do I do that? What is the strategy behind it? How do I engage? How do I penetrate? How do I wow my client? How do I exceed his expectation? How do I put value? Everything is linked. Everything is linked. Activation. So these are just small examples. We'll just run through it. This is a rangoli, which they call it a pukalam. Just look at this. This was goodwill. This came into the Limca Book of World Records in the South. And the shampoo by ITC, Vivil, they partnered with them for this particular event, one-off event. See what happened. Increase in sales and brand value and sales and brand salience. So it's not only about sales out there. No, it's about brand salience. And brand salience is what it sticks to the mind of the customer for a long, long time. That's brand salience. So see what it did, apart from the fact that it was into Limca Book of World Records. So someone in marketing would have thought about it, in marketing communications would have thought about it, discussed it internally, and these two, conceptualization to implementation, let me tell you that some of these projects takes as much as 3 to 6 months. When you start working in the organization, you'll understand. Because these things are not the routine work. These are out-of-body ideas. These are innovative ideas. These are different solutions. So you need to sensitize sales, you need to sensitize marketing, you need to sensitize editorial. You've got sponsors, you've got vendors, you've got clients, and to put the entire piece into takes months. Thematic. This is becoming very popular these days. Max Bupa did. Run. AIDS awareness. There's breast cancer. There is health, various walkathons, marathons across the country. See the amount of goodwill they generate. See the amount of goodwill. Every exercise is not directly related to sales. It's about goodwill. It's about salience. It's about recall. It's about lack of mind. That's what it does. So you may ask why this brand is so strong. It's the number one. Why should it do it? But if it has to be in business, it has to do it. There is no question of why. It's a question of it's a must. But tomorrow the other person comes. Every brand today is replaceable. Let me tell you. There is nothing called monopoly in today's world. Any world of business. Any world of business. You people are all consumers. You go to the shop, you say, I want to decide a Peter England. You find the color there in a Will's Lifestyle. You buy a Will's Lifestyle. Period. 1 minute ke andar. There's no loyalty to Peter England or Will's Lifestyle. You liked it, you took it. That's it. In 1 second, the decision is changed. So, how do we make more relevant to the consumer today is the issue you'll all have to ask. Irrespective of the function you're going to be in. (Clears throat) this was a very, very exclusive exhibition of high-end watches, one of the five-star hotels, niche, for niche audience. So you've got clientele at the upper end of the segment, middle end at the lower end, something for the upper end of the segment. CSR partnership. CSR is big. Today the government is mandating if you've got a turnover of more than 500 crores or a network of 1,000 crores over the last 3 years, then 2% of your net profit has to be given for CSR activity. Yeah? As an organization, can you partner in CSR activity? How do you do it? What are the legalities involved? We're just starting off in this country. Speak. Debate. Speak for themselves. District level, block level, one grand finale. The newspaper was a facilitator as part of the CSR initiative. So the reason why we are showing these examples is see the broad spectrum of work you are expected to do if you are going to be, or your organization is going to be in business. So your domination has got no meaning. You may be number one tomorrow, today, 2 years time, you're going to be down, or even less than that. You talk of the best of organizations 5 years back and see where they are today. They are nowhere. Sure.
So is it important for a startup to do the CSR activities, right?
Startup may not.
That's why, sir, I was asking
may not make that much of sense because there are two kinds. One is the CSR which is mandated by the government. Uske liye to your net worth has to be 500 crores.
Haan, sir.
Or your turnover 1,000 crores for the last 3 years, then you give around, you employ 2%. So that is one. But that doesn't stop you at the individual level to do social work.
So how to make
and increase the community.
So how to make the brand more effective in a public, general public, to make more awareness about our own brand.
So that's exactly what I'm saying. So you'll have to see what is your brand, what is your product category, where are you? This is extremely a complex question. There are no easy answers there. You know, so that's why the reason which I'm showing you is that this brand is number one in South in that particular state, and so see the gamut.
So most of the brands make out the CSR policies and they just regulate it and make out the huge profits from them. But by you, it's a bit of question, it's a bit of situations to compete with those brands.
I won't be able to comment much on the startup part because link of startup and CSR I work it out there. But yes, you are right, because government has not mandated it. While there are regulations there, there's very few percentage of companies in this country which are actually spending money on CSR. So that regulation needs to tighten up. Yes, you're absolutely right, because and secondly, what is happening is that a lot of these single owner driven organizations are also doing CSR so that they get a personal benefit, which benefits the organization, which is actually not CSR activity there. So it's still in the stage of getting refined. So there is a next notification, I think, which is expected in the next few months. So they are refining that.
This is like an ITC brand. They launched Amma Yojana in villages.
ITC has been doing some fantastic work for the last 20 years. They started off with eChopal. Their education initiative many, many years back. They've been doing some fantastic work. All their hotels, if you go, they're all into LEED certified. They're saving energy in a big way. So they're doing, ITC is a conglomerate, I think, which ITC and the Tatas, I think two, three organizations have been doing some pioneering work. I mean, Tatas, even before what CSR was in the country, they've been working. If you ever go to Jamshedpur, you'll see what Tatas have done and what they have been doing. So pioneering work from that angle. So you need to sustain momentum. We need to sustain momentum. Increased circulation goes up, readership goes up, salience goes up, hence revenues goes up. Keep the clients engaged. End of the day, it's all about sustainability. So let's again come back to, after these examples, to key account management. So why do you want key? You need new opportunities. How are you going to grow? Existing client is not going to keep giving you business beyond a point. So how do you go organically and how do you go inorganically? Give solutions. Today the buzzword is talking about solutions. It's not about interaction. It's about solution selling. Can I give him a 360 degree solution? How do I do it? If at all I have to do it. Solutions, overcome barriers. So what's the process? Yeah, the client has needs, you've got skills, you either give products, you give services, you give support, give value. End of the day, you need to ask this question, or your organization needs to ask this question. Whatever product or the service you're offering, does it offer value to the client or the customer, is the question. Value is a huge intangible word, not easily measurable. It's basically a sigma of social and economic benefits. What constitutes value to me may not constitute value to you. What is the value? This is just a figure here. I don't want to scare. Michael Porter has been one of those authors on strategy. So some of you who would know. So he's got his own. So coming back, sell a solution to a customer problem or satisfy your need. Plain and simple. We'll just summarize. We're really running out of time now. Basically, what is it all about? So we are talking about solution selling. Lot of you marketers need to look at this slide very, very importantly. Because we are talking about solutions, we are talking about a concept. Building confidence. Give a solution. How do you counter competition? How do you be one up of competition is the issue. So you need to retain a customer. Which we have talked about retention. How do you retain that customer? Then you need to have new customers, yeah. Then you need to have the existing customers also to grow. Manage customers, they are going to be trust territory. You are not the only client. And you need to go beyond product and benefit selling. So that's all this value which we are talking of. Unless you do that, you're not going to be in business. It's no rocket science, as pure and simple. Yeah? But when we talk of solution selling, see, it's very simple. Talking of solution selling, as I said, a couple of the examples which I had shown you, takes months and months of conceptualization and making it execute operationally. It's a nightmare. So solutions also has its own set of issues. Long period of time. Client is never very clear what does he want. You go to a client will say, ki, boss, mujhe kuch innovative karke dikhao. What is that innovative? He doesn't know. He has no clue. But now, you know, this is normal. Yeah, you come out with a proposal, you know, which is path breaking. So what is that path breaking? Lot of intangibles, lot of question marks. What is the right solution? To execute such projects, huge amount of people are involved from various departments. Again, your skills in handling people, which I was talking of, you'll get, at times one gets frustrated. Because a guy who's a production guy, he has no idea of your business, he will put 3 points. How do you manage? So issues do come in solution selling. But in a nutshell, I think before I wind up, or you need to think on your customer's behalf if you want to be in business or if you want your organization to be in business. Is as clear as that. Because client is not assuring you business at all. No. You can't take the client for granted. So unless you do the thinking part, you're doomed. Thank you. So any questions, any questions? Yeah. Any questions? Any queries, doubts? Anything you want to add, something? You've been quite a good audience, I must appreciate.